Okay. Can anyone say what is a cell?
May I?
Yeah.
Ma'am, a cell is a unicellular organism.
Cell is a unicellular organism. Okay.
Ma'am.
Any more answers? Yeah, Daksh.
Ma'am, a cell is the basic functional unit of life.
Bit of life. Any more answers?
No, may I tell? The basic, the functional and structural unit of life.
Okay. Any more answers?
Ma'am, cell is the basic unit of life.
Basic unit of life. Okay. I asked the definition of cell. I asked what is a cell. Everyone are after giving definition of cell. I asked what is a cell. That's all.
Auntie, every living organism is made up of cells.
Okay, then. Okay, let me put this one in another way. Is this word cell English word? Do you think?
No, ma'am. It is a Latin word.
It's a Latin word.
Meaning room. Meaning a room.
A small room.
A room.
A little room.
A small room. Okay. Now my question is, why the cell definition is so? You people are saying it's a basic structural and functional unit of life. This is what you read according to definition. Why the definition is so?
One, because the cell theory of life, which was put forward by Theodore Schwann and Matthias Schleiden,
okay,
said that the cell
into the subject. Yeah, good, good. But
the cells are the building blocks of life.
Why?
Ma'am, because every living organism, no matter how big it is made up of small cells.
Ma'am, because the major functions of the body are carried out by the cell, and every living organism is made up of many cells.
Okay, that's why the definition is so. We'll start from history, then we'll come to the point why the definition of cell is so. Then we'll get into the concept of today's chapter. Okay, now here, if you observe, in this peak, we have a great scientist named Robert Hooke. Did you people remember about Hooke?
Auntie, he discovered cell in 1665 in a cork with the help of cell design microscope.
Oh, wow. Great. Great that you know much more information. Okay. Now, this Robert Hooke, he is basically not a scientist. He's an architect in London. He was very professional. I mean, he just want to deliver the goods to his customers in a very fine, particular manner. For that purpose, he made an instrument with kind of lenses, which you can see in this picture. Right now, we call it as a microscope. Okay. So using that, he used to observe the different sections of the wood or the cork material he used to provide for his architecture profession purpose. Meanwhile, in past 16th century, suddenly on one day, one good fortunate day, he observed a kind of, this is what Robert Hooke had observed under the instrument which he had made by himself with lenses. So this seems to be closely associated blocks, isn't it? So those closely associated blocks, he named them as cellulae. In Latin word means chambers. Cellulae. Okay, chambers. Now these chambers are nothing but cells. He made a conclusion. And he announced that he discovered cells, which are the minute structures within the subject of cork. Okay. So this is what Robert Hooke had observed. Okay. Now, surprisingly, this Robert Hooke, what observed and announced it as cell, is not exactly cell. Take a look of the statements over here. Actually, what Robert Hooke observed was cell wall of the cell, which is nothing but a dead material. Okay. So this is the brief account of who first discovered cell, but not actually the living cell. Okay. Yeah. See, so if the cell is not discovered in a living state by Robert Hooke, then who's the first scientist who made this great discovery of a living cell? It's as one of your classmates said that in 1665, Robert Hooke observed the cell wall structure in Cork. In 1675, after 10 to 13 years after the discovery of cell, another scientist by name Antoni van Leeuwenhoek. Okay, can you just identify the cells which Antoni van Leeuwenhoek had actually observed under microscope? Red blood cells, white blood cells, then
yeast cells and sperm, sperm and bacteria cells.
Okay, that's good. Okay, so here are the different cells he had made observation. Now, how many of you know about these cells? Red blood cells, WBC, white blood cells. Okay, so red blood cells you'll find in blood. They probably contain a pigment called
hemoglobin.
Yes, hemoglobin. Yeah, right. Acha. Now, red blood cells contains hemoglobin, because of which our blood is red in color, isn't it? So like that, he had observed different living cells by staining them. Staining is a process of coloring the particular subject so that they can be clearly visible under microscope. Yeah. Okay. So now we are getting into the next point regarding cell.